Welcome to part two of upgrading the Nightmare Survival Shooter project from Unity 4 to Unity 5. If you missed part one, please check that out before continuing with this video. In this version of the Nightmares project, we have a pause menu that's been created with the new UI system. The pause menu is called up when you press escape using a script called Pause Manager, which is attached to Menu Canvas. We'll look at this script in more detail later in the video. For more information about creating this type of UI, see the information linked below. Before moving on to scripting, we want to do one more thing in our mixer. We want to expose the volume of the music group and the sound effects group to script control so that we can set them directly without using the snapshot system. We'll click on the music group, right-click on the volume parameter, and choose Expose to Script. We're also going to do this for the sound effects group. Now, in our exposed parameters list, we're going to name these two parameters. We're going to call our first exposed parameter Music Vol, and our second SFX Vol. To rename the parameters, double-click on the parameter names. Now that we've got the audio set up in our project, we're going to move on to adding some scripting control. Let's start by editing the Pause Manager script. We're going to go to the Menu Canvas Game Object, and then double-click on the Pause Manager script to open it in MonoDevelop. Let's just quickly review what we have here. We've added the namespace declaration using UnityEngine.ui, because we're using some of the functions from the UI system, including the canvas variable type. We're also checking if we're currently running in the Unity editor, and if so, we're adding the namespace declaration using Unity editor. We've declared a variable of the canvas type called canvas, and this is the UI canvas. In the start function, we're getting a reference to that using getComponent. In our update function, we're checking to see if the escape key has been pressed. If escape has been pressed, we'll flip the canvas from enabled to disabled or vice versa. We'll also call the pause function. In the pause function, we're setting time.timescale. We're doing this by checking if it's currently set to 0, set it to 1, and otherwise set it to 0. By setting time.timescale to 0, we can freeze the motion of all of the objects in our game. We also have a public function called quit, in which we're checking if we're using the Unity editor. We're going to do editor application.isPlaying equals false, meaning it's going to stop playing the scene, or else we're going to call application.quit, meaning if this was the build of our application, it would actually quit out to the desktop. What we're going to do is we're going to add some stuff to this script to allow it to control our audio mixer. The first thing that we're going to add is another namespace declaration using UnityEngine.audio. This is going to allow us to access members of UnityEngine.audio, including the audio mixer and the audio mixer snapshot classes. We're going to add two public variables of the audio mixer snapshot type. We're going to call these paused and unpaused. These are going to correspond to the snapshots that we created in the first video. We're going to add a new public function under pause. We're going to call this function lowPass. In lowPass, we're going to check if time.timescale is currently equal to 0. If time.timescale is equal to 0, we're going to call the transition to function from the paused snapshot. We're going to pass in the floating point parameter time to reach, in this case, 0.01 seconds. If time.timescale does not equal 0, we're going to call transition to from the unpaused snapshot. With our low pass function declared, we're now going to call it from inside the pause function. Let's save our script and return to the editor. In the editor, we'll see that our pause manager script now has two new variables, paused and unpaused. We're going to set those to our audio mixer snapshots we created earlier using the asset picker. We'll select the paused snapshot. And the unpaused snapshot. Let's play our scene and give it a try. Press escape and see that the paused snapshot has been recalled. And then when we click resume, we can see that unpaused has been recalled. And so we can hear that it's working. In the pause menu, we have volume controls for the music and for the sound effects. We're going to use those to control our audio mixer using scripting. Let's start by creating a new C# script, which we'll call mix levels. We'll double-click it to open it in MonoDevelop. Again, the first thing we're going to start by doing is adding the namespace declaration using UnityEngine.audio. Next, we're going to add a public variable of the audio mixer type called MasterMixer. Because we won't need either the update or the start functions, we're going to delete those. We're going to declare a public function called setSFXLevel. We're going to give setSFXLevel a parameter of the type float called SFXLevel. We're going to use the SFXLevel parameter to pass a floating point value to MasterMixer and use that to change the volume of our sound effects level in our audio mixer. We're going to do this using the setFloat function. SetFloat takes two parameters, a string, which is the name of the exposed parameter that we want to set, and a floating point parameter to set the value. We're going to pass in the string sfxvol, which is the name of the parameter that we exposed earlier in the inspector. We're also going to declare a second public function called setMusicLevel. SetMusicLevel is also going to take a floating point parameter, in this case called music level. In set music level, we're also going to use set float to set the value of our exposed parameter music vol. Let's save our script and return to the editor. In the editor, let's add our mix level script to our menu canvas game object. We're also going to select our audio mixer master mixer as the master mixer variable. Next, in the pause panel, we're going to choose our effects slider game object. In the slider script, you'll see that previously onValueChanged was changing the value of the gun barrel end and the player audio sources directly. Now we can reconnect those to our audio mixer. First, we're going to drag in our menu canvas. We're going to choose from our list of functions found on this game object our mix level script, and we're going to choose the setSFXLevel function from that script. We can remove the connection to the player audio source by selecting it and hitting minus. We're going to do the same thing for our music slider. Drag in our menu canvas game object, choose from our list of functions, in this case, mix levels, set music level. Because we determined that negative 10 decibels was probably the loudest we wanted our music to be in the mixer, we're going to set that in the max value in the slider. We're also going to set the minimum value to negative 80, which will be silent. In the effects slider, we're going to do the same thing, except it's going to be between negative 80 and 0. With that set up, let's play our scene and give it a try. We'll hit escape, adjust the music volume. Let's pull down the sound effects volume too. So there we have it. For more information about audio mixers, snapshots, exposed parameters, and effects, see the information linked below.